In this lesson, you'll discover five common mistakes you might be making that can keep you from sounding fluent and natural in your spoken English. We'll also discuss how to fix these mistakes. Be sure you stay tuned all the way till the end of the lesson, because I think the final mistake I'll share with you is going to surprise you. This is the Clear English Corner, and I'm Keenyn, your Clear English Coach. It's my mission to help you develop your articulation, your prosody, and your voice so that you can be clear, confident, and compelling in English. All right, so five mistakes that can keep you from sounding fluent and natural in English. Mistake number one, saying each word one at a time. When we look at English on a page, the written word, we can see distinct white space between the words. But in spoken English, there is no white space. Instead, the voice flows from word to word as sounds combine together between words within phrases. The key to achieving this sound, that underlying hum in spoken English, is keeping the vocal tract open and relaxed as we speak. A great way to practice this sensation is to sing your words. How are you? How are you? How are you? When we sing, our vocal tract remains open and our voice continues to vibrate as we move from word to word. I have several things I need to do. I have several things I need to do. Singing your words can help your body familiarize itself with what it feels like to keep that vocal tract open and keep the voice vibrating. This doesn't mean you have to be a great singer to practice English. You want to just play with the words, play with the words, play with the words, and play with your voice so that you can become familiar with what that continuity feels like in the body, and then you can apply it to your everyday speech. Mistake number two is speaking in a monotone and not varying your pitch. Engaging and magnetic speakers of English incorporate a lot of vocal variety or musicality in their voice. If you listen closely to a speaker that you admire, you'll notice there's rise and fall. There are changes in pitch as the person moves through words and phrases. It may be challenging for you to hear these changes in pitch and to imitate them in your own speech. Here's what you can do. Choose a speaker that you admire and listen to them speak in short phrases or one sentence at a time. Then try to imitate the underlying melody that you hear. Not the words, but just the melody. You can do this by humming, or using da-da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da-da. So for example, with the phrase, good morning, I could hum, or da-da-da. And what I'm doing is I'm allowing my ears and my brain to bring focused attention to the underlying melody of the words. Da 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 da. The underlying melody of the words. By consciously drawing attention to that underlying melody, you can then go back to the same phrase and imitate it, incorporating that melody in your own words. We have to be able to hear and recognize that underlying musicality and vocal variety in other speakers before we can begin to integrate it into our own speech. Mistake number three, giving equal emphasis to all words and syllables. In English, certain words and syllables are going to stand out and be emphasized more than others. Others are going to be quicker and quieter. It's this contrast between what is emphasized and stressed versus what's not that creates the natural sounding rhythm in spoken English. Again, it may be challenging at first to hear this contrastive rhythm in spoken English, but you can train your ears to detect it. Here's a great way to practice. Again, choose a speaker that you enjoy listening to that has a speech or presentation with a corresponding transcript. For example, if there's a certain podcaster that you enjoy listening to and they have transcripts that accompany their episodes. Another great resource are TED Talks at TED.com, where you can listen to a variety of interesting speakers on endless interesting topics, and each of the speeches has a downloadable transcript. What you want to do is listen to these speakers just short chunks at a time, short phrases and sentences, and see if you can underline the words that are more distinct. You might need to listen to the phrases or sentences a couple of times, but your ear will start to pick out the sounds and words that are more prominent. When you do this type of listening exercise repeatedly, your ears begin to hear that contrastive rhythm more naturally. And again, when you begin to be able to hear the contrastive rhythm, you can then begin to integrate that into your own speech. Mistake number four, not moving or opening the mouth. A lot of my clients and students will come to me speaking like this without really moving the mouth very much. But you'll notice, again, engaging and magnetic speakers open and move the mouth. It's the only way to release a full and resonant sound. It can't happen with your mouth like this. You may not be aware that you're not moving your mouth much, so a great way to practice is to use a mirror as you practice speaking English. If you're feeling really brave, you can also use video. Record yourself speaking and watch the mouth. Is it moving? Is it opening? Does it look relaxed? Before you begin your speaking practice, you can massage your jaw, massage the neck muscles, loosen up the shoulders. We want to make sure that our speech musculature is very relaxed, which makes it easier to move the mouth. Mistake number five. Here's that final mistake that I think may surprise you, and that is speaking too fast. There's a common misconception that in order to sound fluent and natural in English, we need to speak really fast. That if we speak too slow, our listeners will stop listening. In reality, the opposite is true. When we speak too fast, our listeners have to work too hard to understand the words. And as a result, when their listener has to work too hard, they stop listening. So you want to slow your speech in a very natural sounding way. This doesn't mean we speak one word at a time in a weird way. No, rather what this means is embracing the power of a pause, using pauses in between phrases. This allows your listener to process the words that you've just shared. It also allows you time to formulate what you're going to say next, not just what you're going to say, but how you want to say it. Also, emphasizing your most important words, lingering a bit longer on those words, and integrating that natural rhythmic contrast that we talked about earlier can also help you slow your speech in a very natural sounding way. So there you have it, five common mistakes that may be keeping you from sounding fluent and natural in spoken English. I'm curious, are you making any of these mistakes? Let me know by sharing the number of the mistake in the comments below. Number one, saying one word at a time. Number two, using a monotone. Number three, using equal emphasis on all our words and syllables. Number four, not moving the mouth. And number five, speaking too fast. If you found the lesson helpful, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of our upcoming lessons. In the meantime, come on over to the Clear English Corner website for more free pronunciation practice resources. As always, thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you next time.